It's Christmas time. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my short Advent time stories. Windows NT 3.1, if anything, is said to be a beast to install. This certainly is owed to the fact of the limited hardware support it saw in the beginning. Though even in the aftermath, NT 3.1 continued to pose problems, as it wouldn't easily install on anything newer than a 486. So this error message here is actually widely known, pointing exactly at this fact. Easy, huh? Now, if you were to install NT 3.1 on an unsupported CPU, whether it was on real hardware or within a virtualization like VMware, VirtualBox and such, you'd always end up on this error message here. And the solution to it was clear: use either a ready-to-run patch set to replace the initial.inf and setup.inf files to overcome the CPU detection issue, or patch it manually. So far, so good. But the catch is, this makes only sense on real hardware or within VMware VirtualBox and other virtualization products which pass the CPU characteristics and features into the VM. But what if I told you this error here was observed on 86box? The thing is, 86box does a full CPU emulation, that means it doesn't pass your actual CPU into the VM, but really goes and emulates whatever CPU is selected in the VM properties. So if you go with an 86box configuration, for example the one provided here on betawiki.net, your NT 3.1 should run like a charm and one should never see this actual error message. As I had actually gotten to run NT 3.1 on VirtualBox on another occasion using the patch method myself, I tried repeating it here on 86box. The easiest is to boot from DOS format drive C and copy the i386 folder over to the hard drive. Then replace the files by the patched versions and run winnt.exe to kick off the setup from DOS. But what a downer when I found the patch didn't help. Alright, I eventually came across that post on the PCem Forums where someone said the image might have been tampered with. Could it be? And yes, inspecting my ISO image revealed the changed files originating from a later date. The odd thing was that I replaced them with patched files myself, still ending up on the same error. Could it be? And yes, when trying a diff on both files, the ones in the ISO image versus the ones I had downloaded, it becomes obvious they're identical, so neither would of course install, as obviously the patches seem to be corrupted in some way. So I went to get another ISO from WinWorld PC, which then led me to install NT 3.1 without any further issues. If anything, then this experience helped me to identify an install image in my collection which is obviously not sane and had been tampered with. Needless to say, I deleted it right away. What do you think about it? Did you ever stumble into any kind of install issues because of using tampered media? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector and this was my short Advent time story for today. Thanks for watching and see you again tomorrow when I'm revealing why I had to install NT 3.1.